This video is photoshopped. No one was actually injured in the making. It simply demonstrates circular and rotational motion very well. In this video, multiple people are riding on an amusement park swing. There are two types of motion being displayed by this ride. The first is circular motion, which is demonstrated by the people sitting on the swings. The second is rotational motion, which is shown by the actual circular structure on the top of the ride. Now let's begin to analyze the mathematics behind this thrilling ride.
We'll start by explaining the circular motion. The equation we will use to find centripetal force is mass multiplied velocity squared and divided by the radius. Let's break down the variables now. The radius is 16 meters, the total mass is 100 kilograms. The angle of the ride is 67.5 degrees, and the time it takes for a person to complete one revolution is 6.2 seconds. We're still missing a value for velocity, however. So now we will divide 2 pi by 6.2 seconds to find the angular velocity. This gives us an angular velocity of 1.01 radians per second. Now we will multiply the angular velocity by the radius to get a tangential velocity of 16.16 meters per second. This velocity can now be applied to the centripetal force equation, and we receive a value of 6,528 meters. Now we will explain the calculations for rotational motion. We'll begin with the variables again. The radius is 4 meters, the initial angular velocity is 0 radians per second, and the final angular velocity is 1.01 radians per second. The mass of the ride is 3,000 kilograms, and it takes 6.2 seconds for the ride to complete one revolution. The moment of inertia can be found by multiplying 1/2 by the mass and the radius squared. By using the values we have, we obtain a moment of inertia of 24,000 kilograms times meters per meter squared. The final angular velocity was found by dividing 2 pi by the time, 6.2 seconds. We can find torque by multiplying the moment of inertia and angular acceleration. Since we are missing angular acceleration, we can find it by subtracting initial angular velocity by final angular velocity and dividing by time. We get 0.652 meters per second squared. Now we get a torque of 15,648 newtons times meter squared.
We hope our video has been helpful in explaining circular and rotational motion. Thank you for watching, and remember, correct calculations like ours could prevent an accident like this. On a final note, no participants were injured in the making of this video.